Nasi goreng to you all. I know that's a Malaysian, Southeast Asian noodle dish, and it's very tasty. I did record this last night in glorious Technicolor at about 10 o'clock last night. This is FanFormula. It's back, but not really. It's Project Formula. We're not sure. I sort of coined Selwyn Circuit, but I'm not even sure that's a bit... No, she'll shout at me if I call it that. Vicky has decided to kind of semi-resurrect questions this week because Ailish has disappeared to do work. So she's resurrected the questions and we'll go about answering them. Apologies, because I said earlier I did this last night, but I'm really quite ill with something really quite terrible. So if I it all goes a bit mad and mental. I'm wandering around at the moment for the last couple of days. It's like being drunk the whole time. And it's really messing with my mind completely. So I thought before I get even worse and end up in an A&E unit somewhere in the West Midlands, if you're in one and you work in one at the moment, I may be coming to see you within the next 48 hours because this ain't cool. So I thought, right, bash it out. Get something into the internet just so you can, you know, if I die, remember me with something quite fondly. So I am wearing a shirt and tie. No, I'm not going to die, don't worry. Christ. Anyway, question one. The Bahrain Grand Prix saw the fierce racing between Jensen Button and Sergio Perez. What's your take on the lack of McLaren team orders? Brilliant. I think it's fantastic. I think that Martin Whitmarsh is really, really, really lucky in the fact that he's got two drivers that he can sort of semi-bang their heads together in their respective authority. He doesn't have a Vettel or a problem child who will ignore what he wants to say. Or in squash. Drink champions. which is easy for him. But I do think this time, I'm all for racing. I'm all for non-team orders because we've seen how it manipulates previous races, even the season. But I think Sergio did go a bit too far. If you get to the stage whereby you're taking bits of your car off, crashing into your own teammate, that's not cool. You need to bang the heads together. But I think it's good for him because he's young enough to appreciate that. He's not old and bitter and twisted and sort of egomaniacal like Vettel is, that he can go, no, I will not listen to anything and carry on. I think it's a benefit to us that we saw racing, but it's also a benefit to him and us in the long run that now they've gone, you can race, but not stupidly. Okay, chaps? I think it's good that there's a lack of team orders. I just think it's good. It's positive. Vettel becomes the first double winner of the season in Bahrain. Will anyone take their first ever F1 win in 2013? Potentially no. I still see it being the top seven that have already won in their careers, and some of them indeed in career. Potentially only Grosjean, because he's the only person of the top four teams that hasn't won ever, and he's shown the potential, and he's shown Lotus have shown that their car is capable of winning races. So potentially it's only a matter of time. We don't know going into the European super season whereby stuff will go mad and we'll get a massive sort of space race, an overhaul of aerodynamics and all of that, the associated. So, but even then, you're not looking at like a Maldonado did last year. You're not looking at a Maldonado or a Bottas or a Hulkenberg or a Sebastian Gutierrez to do well, really. So I think it's Grosjean or no one for a first ever win, because no one really looks. I mean, Suter. I mean, maybe Paul de Rest. It's boring. Suter maybe at a push, but other than that, Grosjean, because it just seems a logical progression and a potential conclusion to this answer, which is going to stop. Question numéro 3. There have been much debate whether Pirelli tyres have taken tyre degradation too far. What are your thoughts? I have many thoughts. I think it has taken it too far. Before, you looked at aerodynamic, You looked at strategy, you looked at weight, you looked at driving, you looked at track, you looked at weather, you looked at pit stops, you looked at other people's strategies. Now, all of that aside, you could have a perfect package, a massively brilliant package that's there at a race weekend. And it's being decided on the quality of the rubber. That's a lesson in life, kids. But, yes, it is. It's not being decided on strategy anymore. You could have the best thing in the world, but if it comes down to it, after six laps, you could be leading the race, you could be saving your fuel, you could be bossing it. But if you have to come in for the tyres, that blows the whole thing out of the water. So I think it was really good when Pirelli took over, because Michelin and Bridgestone, it was too predictable in that sense. Except the Grand Prix where all the tyres blew up and everyone retired because they didn't want to kill themselves. but Pirelli came in, did really well, took the proverbial bull by the horns and made it work from a tyre point of view. But I think there is a line, a fine line, and I think they just crossed it. So hopefully, with this potential rumoured new five-year deal in penned for tyres, maybe they'll just sort of not rein back a bit, because that's like a Concord moment, but maybe. I think they've gone a bit too far with degradation, with the fact that you can like sneeze on tyres now and they'll just collapse. You don't want that. You want it to play a part, but not be the critical part. So yeah, great package, let down by the rubber this season thus far. Hopefully we'll get better going forward. Bonus, construct your ideal F1 dream team from the 2013 grid. I'm torn. Well, Jensen Button is the first driver, but then potentially Mark Webber, because I'd be a bit more relaxed, but then you'll have to change them. But Mark Webber's off to Porsche. Apparently, I'm the only person that knows this, but there's got to be more people that I follow on Twitter that know this more firmly than purely a rumor. It's just. I'll keep asking the people I know with endurance racing to see what happens. Maybe a young driver, maybe a Hulkenberg. Maybe if Button is content with being maybe an equal driver, maybe put a Fernando Alonso in there, because I think even he is a bit of a tit at times. He's mellowed, and I think he's still one of the cleverest drivers on the grid when it comes to thinking rear wing underneath his car aside. Maybe a Jules Bianchi. As a young driver, because he's showing a lot of potential, and I think he needs to get over that, get out of that Marussia as quickly as possible. We could have team principal. Oh god, team principal. Ooh. Cyril Abitbol, because Cyril Abitbol is a brilliant name, and he's really quiet, and no one knows what he's up to this season since he took over. And his name's Cyril, so he could be like a secret Cyril. If you're under the age of, say, 20, you won't get maybe why that's funny, but it is, trust me. but then you could go mad. You could say, let's put in an Irish team owned by Eddie Jordan. And we'll put in Stefan O. Domenicali, Fernand O. Alonso, and Sergei O. Perez. Sort of an Irish, kind of Hispanic, Italian-y melting pot of passion and potatoes. Let's just go mental, people. So we could do that, or we could have my team. I said that's not about like, woo! No, my team, because as you all know, it was my birthday last Thursday. The 25th of April, majestic day. Share it with many wonderful people, including many famous people. It's quite nice, including but not limited to Felipe Massa, Jean-Éric Vergne, Guido van der Garde. So we could have them. So me, Massa, van der Garde, and Vergne. And then every time about like the Bahrain or the Chinese Grand Prix, we could have a massive party and you're all invited and it'd be amazing. So maybe them as well. That sounds like a cool team, doesn't it? So we're going with the first proper team, then we're going with an Irish team, then we're going with my team. But then we've got like Rear, I mean, we can't go mad with, oh, let's put like a Rear Jackman in or this. But I mean, we could have, Will Garside, you know Will Garside, working to be the best aerodynamicist in F1. We could have him, because I'm all in for people training up. There's notion of apprentices. So if he wants to be an aerodynamicist, he could be Adrian Newey's aerodynamicist. There's all these people at the top level that you don't get kind of going down in front of the media spotlight. And if they, you know, they all say, oh, I can work in F1. You know, okay, put your money where your mouth is. Work in F1. If you can't hack it, there's like 50 other better, more passionate, better qualified people right behind you willing to take it. And it would be survival of the fittest. And then when you got to someone who was genuinely brilliant, you'd have a fantastic sport because everybody would be at the top of their game. What is not to love? Well, many things. So there you go. I should leave you with that. It's 11 minutes long. Enjoy my Mark Webber haircut, as my other half said. It does look a bit Mark Webbery. Enjoy the fact that I'm wearing effectively a shirt and tie for your delectation. And I should leave you with news that... some of you who have been watching my Twitter saw last night that the Aston Villa game, kudos to Dean, he's probably very still hungover. I predicted in the first half that Christian Benteke would score a second half hat-trick, and knowing Belgians for nearly 20 years, he went and bloomin' did it, didn't he? So I'm still on cloud nine, actually on cloud nine, and also just a bit in my head because it's still a bit like spinny. So apologies if in the last like 15 minutes of your life watching this is still a bit like, because I'm a bit like, it's just spaced out. I think even though it's like 7:30, I might just go to bed. I'm that broken. Or I'll watch Real Madrid play Dort. But not with beer. Can't drink at the moment because I'll break otherwise. Anyway, enough of me moaning about the fact that I'm close to death or feeling a bit crap. Apologies for swearing if crap's a word. And I'll speak to you soon. I'll see you online. Look after yourselves. And I always say that and I always mean it. Especially, you know, looking at me. Look after yourself, Dom. Look at yourselves. Look after yourselves. I look forward to whoever has taken up this great mantle that Vicky has thrown to us. I look forward to watching yours. So look after yourselves and catch yam later.